Okay, good morning. Today I'm going to speak of the Tree Keeping Fund. Now, a Tree Keeping Fund is a new way to manage trees in cities and residents all around the world. A very, very simple way to avoid corruption, to avoid arbitrations, litigations, to avoid all kinds of strifes. Now, what it is it's just back to the trained professionals. The trained professionals being college graduates. It goes with them being the before any action is taken on any tree, whether on the city grounds, whether it's on a public ground, a private ground, residential grounds. Before any of those are cut, we have the tree keepers. Now, the tree keepers are paid for by citizens. Okay, a very small token amount. They're paid for, and that's a yearly wage. So they are paid regardless if the tree is cut down or if the tree is kept. They are paid. So it's not the type of you are in the pocket now, you get paid. It's the way it is now. You're the resident, you pay the person to cut the tree down. It's in the advantage of anybody involved in that situation who's being paid to say, yes, we cut the tree down. Okay, so this is a retract and saying, no, that's not going to happen any longer. You put the person in there, the predecessor, in the very first part that says, no, I am the decisional process. So when you put the decisional process in front of everybody else before any of their weapons come out, the deciders, when they are paid regardless, then it is a fair system. Then it is not a corrupt system. Okay? So, when we're looking at our deciders and our decision makers, we're looking at climatologists, we are looking at botanists, we're looking at wildlife, habitational professors and graduates, we're looking at biologists. We're looking at all of these, this group, okay? Now, I went with five, and I want them from at least three different colleges. All of this is to cut corruption, remember. We have to cut down corruption because it's way too easy. Way too easy that the tree arborist all of a sudden wants to be paid. So to cut corruption, we have three different colleges that they come from. They have to come from at least three different ones. Now, in lieu of them, it has to be three professors. Okay. Now, they're going to have a governing body over each of their actions as well. Before and after shots of the region, of the tree, before it was taken, and the tree after. So any action that they've been involved with, they're going to have a record. And this is a record that should be available publicly online. Okay. So these particular college graduates, I would like to say, you know, the people that are almost there to graduate also, I would love to include them. You know, they're getting into their thesis time and everything. But this group, they're going to have a record that follows them. And we're going to have a higher group of supervisors. And these are postdoctorate supervisors in the same field of study, world climate, all of these very, very important behaviors of planetary, of where we are, what we're doing, desertifications, all of this. Microclimates, all of these greats. We need the postdoctorates then to supervise. Are going to have to run through those lists that are already going to be provided and say, I don't know, this guy is not making good decisions. or this one isn't making good decisions, and so they're going to be cut out of the loop, and they'll lose their job that way. So we will have a watchdog group that'll just be the higher postdoctorate supervisors, running through what they've been, what they have been agreeing to and not agreeing to. And I believe that's going to be a really good predecessor to the actual event. Okay, the actual event is when they are bringing out their weapons and they start intimidating people in the neighborhood. That actual event becomes dangerous. So who pays for that event? Now, it's actually been ordered, let's say it was a resident who ordered it, or a public golf course who ordered it, they at that point make a payment for the labor involved. They do not pay for the decisional. The decisional is paid by the citizens. Okay. The decisional is nothing to do with the actual labor. The labor of the event is paid for the person or persons who ordered it, whether it is a city government, a kingdom, or a resident, okay, private or public. Once the actual labor is happening, that has to be paid by them. Now, unfortunately, if it is a city, that looks like the residents have to pay again. But that's the way it goes. That is the way it goes. We just have the decisional one, and then you would have, so it is a surplus tax moment in a city environment. But it is a surety. It is a make sure they're doing it correctly. Okay. Now, when you have further on, you have in a kingdom environment, that taxation would be paid by the churches and the casinos. Those taxes. So you would not, that wouldn't go on to the citizens. Now, when you go into normal citizens, it will go into those select businesses. When you are going into the private residences and they demand a request, and it's on their grounds or it's on their golf course, that has to be paid by them. Okay. So nothing to do with. So I put all this on the website and I made it a little chart there, so it's a little more clear understanding. And so this will stop much of the battles that have been going on, and it will be a fair system, okay, to implement all around the world.